primary care. There's about 600 or 700 people there. And it's a mix between application engineers, our salespeople, and customers, actually. So it's a place where customers can come and we can innovate together. So we have this idea of what we call co-creation. How do you create something? How do you think about your customer with how they make money? What do they need? And actually designing something which is going to help them, not what you think they need. And being close to those customers in Chengdu was so important, and it's proving highly successful.
Who are the customers? Who are the ones coming?
Doctors, okay. Physicians, locally.
So people who will work with the equipment,
yeah,
at the end of the day.
They'll be the end users. So rather than trying to guess what they need, it's working with them and saying, we need an ultrasound we can take out to the country. At the moment, if you had an ultrasound, you'd have to go to a hospital. So we worked with a lot of these physicians, and we came up with a handheld ultrasound. It was designed in China, but it had a lot of help from around the world, our experts in Norway and the United States. And it's basically like a mobile phone with a probe. It's very neat. So it means the doctor can take the equipment to the patient anywhere in China. And if you think about Western China, there's 500 million people out there, and that's an important part of the market. So that's been a great example of...
Right, not only affect the outer reaches of the smaller towns and cities, but as you said, abroad, this is able to use in other markets around the world.
That's right, and yeah. that particular product is actually sold in India, in Africa, in Russia, in Latin America. So in fact, what it does, we didn't think about it at the time, it almost replaces the stethoscope, actually. So it's a
double
very
use, yes.
Yeah, so it's a very neat application, mm-hmm, which is designed for the Chinese market here but gone global. As I look at the healthcare industry, I think the next few years are going to be extremely exciting, and China's going to lead the world here, and we're happy to be part of this.
Let's talk about clean energy. You just mentioned that.
Yeah.
Can you explain clean energy in a very simple way? I know a lot of media and a lot of individuals, we don't really get it. We don't understand.
Yeah.
We hear coal energy can be clean or nuclear energy is the best.
Yeah.
Tell us. Help us understand this.
Yeah, it's a complex topic. We do a lot in the energy space. About 25% of the globe's electricity is made by our equipment. So we're big in the energy space. And our philosophy is we innovate technology in all the areas, different parts of energy, and let the customer decide. So we're big in wind. We're big in solar. We're big in gas, heavy-duty gas turbines, so we have a collection of different energy portfolio. When we talk about clean, it's kind of interesting. I came down from Beijing today. That's not clean. The air there is affected because so much of the generating capacity in China is coal. Mm-hmm. That's understandable. China's gone through this amazing growth over the last 20 years. It's fueled by coal, which is the cheapest way to make electricity, but it's also the dirtiest. And there's cheaper ways to, sorry, there's more efficient and cleaner ways to make electricity. One big area we believe is in gas, natural gas, a lot cleaner. You don't have the emissions out of natural gas. It's a lot cleaner to deal with. And the problem with China, it doesn't have that enough natural gas. So over the last few years, it's been working on pipelines, building LNG terminals to bring gas into China. And gradually you'll see more power stations using natural gas. And that significantly changes the emissions. I look at China as being on a 20-year into a 50-year journey, right? So it's just got all very concentrated very quickly. So I totally believe China can overcome the environmental issues. And I think there's thinking about it the right way. But clean energy is key, really key.
Clean energy and also the wind and the solar you mentioned earlier too. Is China leading the way in some areas for that, or where should we look for the countries leading the way?
I think it's important to, if you look at the national power generation portfolio, let's say, there's about 1,000 gigawatts of power. That's a lot. That's about the same as the United States, actually, in aggregate. The difference is China has to double that, which is, you think about it, double that in the next 10 years.
Right.
It's extraordinary. And one statistic I like, actually, visit. The United Kingdom, where I come from, has installed capacity of 70 gigawatts of power.
Okay.
China will put new capacity of 100 gigawatts every year, right? So it's doing a UK and a half every year in China. So, and it has to do that in a way as it thinks about its portfolio. So No, you want to use renewable.